And on the track now, a man who knows the way to victory lane here at Daytona. He has won here in the ARCA Series. He's won here in the Camping World Truck Series. Matter of fact, won the first ever Truck Series race here. And he's won here in the Nationwide Series as well. Mike Wallace.
The Johnny Davis team, they've really upped their game this year. They've got some good new equipment. You know, the cars really look good. They come to this race with a lot of hopes to win because Mike Wallace has so much success. So far, seven.
You see his family, they're excited for him. And he is really so good at this track. He's taken equipment that shouldn't have been up front a number of times and puts it up there just because of his understanding of the draft and his abilities here.
So Mike Wallace qualifying seventh for now out of 29 cars that have gone.
It's a pro motor. I'll give you that. Oh, yeah, that's who built it, too.
From Daytona International Speedway, this is the Motor Racing Network,
yeah.
The voice of NASCAR.
It is, I think.
Man, I think,
hey, who was the highest qualifying Toyota motor?
I didn't know how he lost the pack, but
yeah.
He was trying to hang in the back and protect his car, so I'm wondering if that's not an intentional strategy. Maybe it really was, if he really can't
just like
practice.
I thought, Mike Bliss, the highest qualifying Daytona motor. I mean, the highest qualifying Toyota motor,
Sometimes you just have to be lucky. Just before this, you see Mike Wallace in 0-1, him and Kenny were making a lot of headway going to the front. I'm sure that was Robert Richardson that was sideways down in 1-2. Benny Gordon shuffled back a little bit. You see, here comes Tony Stewart, has Elliott Sadler on his bumper. And to the front, Sam Warner doing well.
Look back up,
Wallace, and that kind of separated him from Sam Warner. Just for a split second, they were able to drive by them.